Greetings and welcome to LGR Oddware, where we're taking a look at hardware and software that is odd, forgotten, and obsolete. And this episode is going to be focusing on the mouse pen, the natural way to input. Yeah, because nothing's more natural than like a large electric toothbrush between your fingers inputting stuff into DOS and Windows 3.1. Oh yeah, let's take a look at this weirdness. Yep. This is the mouse pen. It exists from a company called ICMS, a rather prestigious name, standing for International Machine Control Systems. And later it was sold under the Appoint brand, and this retailed for $129 back in 1990. And this was for MS-DOS computers and, you know, like Windows 3 or anything really that was compatible with the Microsoft mouse drivers. Although later, they did release a MousePen Pro, which is a sleeker and more improved version, supposedly. I don't have one of those. And there was also the MousePen Mac, which was ADB compatible. And then there was the MousePen Portable, which is, again, really like the same thing. It just has a shorter cable and a carrying case and maybe a little different design. But yeah, we're going to be taking a look at the MousePen Original right here. It is important to note that this is really just a mouse. It's not a light pen. It's not a drawing tablet. It's got regular optomechanical sensors, just a mouse plastic ball underneath. So why is this odd? Well, I find more of the story behind it to be a little odd. Really, the company said that the idea was that people always reach for a pen before they'll reach for a mouse. So, you know, obviously, make a mouse shaped like a pen. That's Oddware to me. And, you know, that's the whole forgotten part of it and obsolete, because these ideas that people really just never would reach for a mouse before they would reach for a pen, you know, that's just old and antiquated and wonderful, and things like this existed because of it. This was really geared towards laptop users in the transition area from when they were going from DOS over to graphical user interfaces like Windows, because, you know, laptops just didn't have a mouse built in and mice were becoming really, really popular. And it was also meant for like CAD work and desktop publishing and anything really that needed more precise movements than maybe the traditional mouse could provide. And it would automatically switch between 50 to 1000 PPI, or pulses per inch, some acceleration or, I don't know, smoothing, whatever you want to call it, going on. All right, so inside the box we get a bunch of goodies, including, of course, the mouse pen itself. And yeah, this thing seriously does look like an electric toothbrush to me. I mean, if you don't think too hard about it, then you can see like a Crest logo right there. But yeah, it's honestly just a pen-shaped mouse. You've got left click, right click over here, and then there's the regular optomechanical ball. It's just a little plastic rollerball thing, super cheap feeling. Whole thing is super cheap feeling, but that's how you go for freaking $129, I guess. Yeah, right. And yeah, you also get the end of it here, which it is PS2 compatible, and that is IBM PS2, not the PlayStation 2. To weirdos, don't know your computers. And also, it comes with an adapter for different serial ports. So yeah, 9 or 15 pin, whichever one you want to do. Let's take a look at some of the other things that it came with, though. You also got the 3.5-inch disc with the drivers, memory residence stuff, and some utilities. And also on 5.25-inch floppy. That's cool. These are the things that it comes with here. I think Telepaint was the main like program that it came with to sort of demonstrate it, which we'll take a look at, because why not? And then the mouse pen itself. The guide to operations. It's really, really simple. You don't need all of this stuff. Most of it is just to get like the different menus and commands and stuff for all sorts of programs that it doesn't even come with to work. Like DBase and whatever else. It's all in there, because I guess they were thorough like that. That's nice of them. Telepaint. Pretty much just a paint program, and man, this manual right here is super yellow, but that's cool. It adds character. Oh yeah, and it also came with this piece of wood in the box. I am genuinely not sure what this is for. It's a block of wood with a hole in it. I don't think it actually, does it hold the pen? I mean, it kind of does. It's like not a very good pen holder, but I don't know. Whatever, man. I just got this thing off eBay, so people stick the most random stuff inside these boxes sometimes. let's go ahead and plug this thing in and demonstrate the mouse pen. All right, so I've got the mouse pen plugged into the NCR Comten 386SX. I love this computer. And yeah, in theory, all we should need is the disk in here and the driver installed into memory. And yeah, I said I didn't need drivers earlier, and it doesn't exactly. It's supposedly Microsoft Mouse compatible, but you know, it still needs something for certain systems, and this is using MS-DOS 6.2. So that is one of those things. So let's see here. All right, so it's just mouse.com. And there you go. It says it is installed on COM1. Let's see if it is. Get rid of this stupid thing. Actual Microsoft mouse? Get out of here with that crap. We have the ICMS mouse pen. Oh, this is going to be great. Actually, there's a pen test. Let's see if that works. okay. Test the mouse pen. All right. So in theory, so I've got a little, got a mouse cursor moving. And that's about as awkward as you'd imagine. Okay, well, it seems to be working just fine. So let's get out of here and actually try a thing. And it does come with, what is it called? Telepaint. So it's not PC paint. Is this PC paint? It's PC paint. This is Telepaint. This is Telepaint. All right, where did I installed it earlier. T-Paint. I wish there was a T-Paint executable I could run, but anyway. All right, so this is Telepaint, and, well, let's see. As for the mouse, well, you kind of have, you know, this is your left mouse button, this is your right mouse button, and the thing is, you do have to hold it at just the correct angle to get anything to actually work, and that's to be expected, because it really is, it is just a mouse. And so instead of, you know, the normal ball on the end here being that size, and at the bottom you have this little bitty one that's a little bit larger than a BB. Actually, it's about the size of maybe like a buckshot, or that's a little, maybe a little larger than that, but yeah. So you have to hold it like flat. Let's try to draw something. Yeah, that's good. It's not the most accurate I've ever drawn with a mouse device, but that's okay. Let's see if maybe we can fill it in with some green. Yeah. Oh man, I love these old paint programs. Seriously, I gotta do a whole video on these sometime. But yeah, this is, it's working. Oh, love that draw time. Oh, I just want to see that again. I'm having way much, like, much more fun with this actual, the paint program as opposed to the mouse. But yeah, it works. Honestly, this is not the worst thing I've ever used at all. In fact, it's totally decent. My only thing is, I'm used to a mouse, and I like a mouse. This, I could make something way much more detailed, and there are just better devices for doing input like this. Frick. Okay. And there were back then, too, and I've got some of them. So, you know, it's like, what? Why? Why would I use this? Another thing is that the little rollers are so tiny that it seems like something could go wrong so very easily, because it already has, like, problems going left and right, but these things are clean. I've cleaned it out and everything, but I don't know. It just seems like any slight, tiny little imperfection would just be that much more noticeable on something this small. The other thing really is just the angle that you have to hold it at. You can't... I want to hold it like this, like I would hold a pen, but no, I have to hold it like this, and it's not ideal. But I will say that as far as Oddware goes, and some of the things that are just absurd that I've used on this show, this is not one of them. It's not absolutely absurd. It's just like a really early attempt at doing a pen-shaped mouse. And, you know, these aren't like unheard of things even nowadays. Did I just freeze Arkanoid? I think I did. But yeah, I mean, you've got things like the Genius Pen Mouse and even the G-Stick. That were, I think that was a Kickstarter. you know, for a pen-shaped mouse. So people still want these kinds of devices, but this is not the one to, this is not the one that won, if you know what I mean. But it seemed to be pretty popular. I mean, as far as people, like, you know, buying them, obviously. Oh. What's weird, though, is that, frick, that sort of acceleration thing going on. Like, see, if I do this, but if I do just a little bit more, it speeds up so much, which makes it, for a game like Arkanoid here, it just makes it kind of ridiculous. That, and it has a real problem going left for some reason, and I'm using it on a Max Payne mouse pad here, so should be just fine, but it's not. But yeah, that acceleration, I think you can actually turn it off, like in a driver configuration of some kind. Oh, frick. That going left is a real issue. Oh my word. Now this really sucks. I keep rubbing on these edges as opposed to the ball itself. I have to remember. That's not going to work. Do I have anything else that I can play with a mouse? I think I have lemmings on here, maybe. Oh, this is... So this is Kovacs lemmings. That's kind of a weird one, but cool, whatever. I don't know. Sometimes it's fine. Seem to be having some major problems with Arkanoid, so... Maybe that's just sort of a thing where it needs such... I mean, it looks at just, I think, the X-axis. It doesn't look at Y at all. I don't know. It seems to be fine here. At least good enough to get my lemmings stuck in between the V and the O. Let's just blow them up. Who needs these guys? Die, you stupid lemmings. But yeah, I mean, that is the mouse pen. It doesn't suck. It's not something I would ever use in any kind of frequency, but it doesn't suck. So, there is that. And that's all for this episode of Oddware on the mouse pen. I hope you found it as natural a way to input as I did. And hey, if you enjoyed this, then I've got a lot more Oddware episodes, and plenty more are incoming, as well as reviews and videos on old games, new games, hardware of other kinds, all here on this channel, so subscribing would be beneficial if you have not already. And you can also follow and interact with me on Twitter and Facebook, as well as support the show in general on Patreon. It not only lets you see videos like this earlier than anywhere else, but it also gets you some other cool perks, so go over there and check it out if you're curious. And as always, thank you very much for watching.